Now, if you see in figure 2, okay, this figure 2 will explain you about the direction of the electric field. Now, there is a minus Q charge at point A and there is a plus Q charge at point B. Correct? So, there is a test charge which is positive. So, if we see the force between test charge and the charge which is placed at A minus Q, it will be towards A. Whereas, due to the point B, what will be the direction of the force as well as the direction of electric field? That is away from P. So, this one I am writing as EA and this I am writing as E due to B. This is the angle theta and this is also the angle theta. So, after knowing these two are the direction, resolve EA and EB into its component. So, what is to be done? We have to resolve. What is to be resolved? EA and EB. These are to be resolved because EA and EB are the direction of the electric field due to the charge at B and due to the charge at A. So, when you resolve it, you will find it EA will break into two components, one along x axis, another one along y axis. So, how do I come to know which one is cosine function and which one is sine function? So, this is theta. This alternate interior angle is a theta. So, this becomes EA cos theta and this becomes EA sin theta. Similarly, resolve EB. One component will come along the y component and another one of EB will come along x axis. Correct? So, this is the horizontal x axis. So, if you write it, this will be EB sin theta and this will be EB cos theta. Now, how do I come to know this is cos theta? Now, see this angle theta. This theta is corresponding to this one. So, this is corresponding to this and this is corresponding to this. So, due to this angle theta, EB's component will be EB cos theta and this will be EB sin theta. Now, if you see EB sin theta and EA sin theta. So, EB sin theta and EA sin theta, they are opposite to each other as well as equal. Why? Because electric fields due to A and B are equal. Okay, so they will cancel each other. Therefore, they cancel each other. So, when they cancel each other, so what is the resultant? So, resultant field is due to the cosine component. So, cosine component is EA cos theta and EB cos theta. So, once I know these two components, then to find out the resultant, so this is the back direction of the electric field. So, resultant will be in the direction of EA and EB cosine component. So, this is the direction of the E electric field. So, what is the value of EA and EB? So, let me first calculate. So, electric field due to A, use the formula for the electric field due to point charge, KQ upon R square. What is R? AP square. So, what is AP? AP I have written here. So, KQ upon under root R square plus A square whole square. So, this whole square get cancelled. This become AQ upon R square plus A square. And if you find out the EB, EB will also be same as instead of AP, I will write it as BP square. So, this become KQ upon under root R square plus A square whole square. This get cancelled. So, what you are observing from here is that both EA and EB are equal. Therefore, EA and EB, they are equal to each other. Correct? They are equal. So, when they are equal, so put these value in this to get the resultant. Now, to find out the resultant, therefore, the E resultant is equals to EA cos theta plus EB cos theta. And we know that EA cos theta and EB cos theta are equal. Therefore, we can write it as 2EA cos theta. Put this value of EA or EB from equation either 1 or from 2. Correct? In equation number 3. So, this becomes KQ upon R square plus A square cos theta. Now, in the equation 4, cos theta is unknown. Therefore, from triangle, if you come back to this triangle POA, from triangle POA, cos theta is equals to base upon hypotenuse. What is base? Base is A. So A. What is hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is AP. And what is AP? Under root R square plus A square. This value of the cos theta, you have to place it in equation 4. Therefore, equation 4 becomes E total is equals to 2KQ upon R square plus A square into what is cos theta? A upon R square plus A square to the power half. So what I have done? Under root, I have written in the form of half. Now this is an identity, base same, power will be added. So 2KQA upon R square plus A square to the power 3 upon 2. Now if you see here 2, Q and A, okay, so if you get it here, then what you will get? So I am erasing this, and this equation I am writing it. So E total is equals to K Q 2A upon R square plus A square to the power 3 upon 2. And this is called as dipole moment, since P is equals to Q into 2A. So therefore E total can be written as K P upon R square plus A square to the power 3 upon 2. So this is your fifth equation, correct? Now for short dipole, as we know that this question always comes for short dipole. Short dipole when R is greater than A. So A is ignored. A is ignored. So when A is ignored, the E total can be written as KP upon R square to the power 3 upon 2. 2 get cancelled. So E total is equals to KP upon RQ. So this is the resultant field of the resultant field for the equatorial position. And here you also you will find that it is inversely proportional to the RQ. Thank you.